Garçons et filles, mesdames et messieurs, bienvenue à bord du train à pointe droite au Canada. Le train à bord duquel vous voyagez est des marchandises dans le plus grand capital vers la fin des années
2020.
Oh, who is Tommy? Wow, well, it's a good question. Well, first of all, Tommy is a friend to everyone. And he's a Facebook friend to many. And he's a high school student, a hard worker, and of course, he's a son, a brother, a cousin, a grandson, and a nephew. He's a YouTube star. He's also an athlete, an amazing athlete. He is also a story writer and a storyteller. He's also a blogger, and he's also a person with autism. But most of all, he's just Tommy.
Hi, my name's Tommy Des Brisay.
I said, what do you think autism means? And he said, autism means friendship. Very confidently, he said, autism means friendship. And I thought, wow, that's really cool, because he goes to school at the autism unit. It says on the door, autism unit. That's where his friends are. So why wouldn't he think that would be what it means? So that was really special.
Autism means good.
So it's kind of one of those things where if you watch a kid and you listen and you remember that a person with autism is a person first.
Delicious! Eating greens is a special treat. Makes it straight and tall body.
One of the things he showed early on was this interest in heights and climbing. Any opportunity he had to climb something high, trees, railings, like we couldn't go anywhere where there was a railing. So anytime there was a handrail, he'd want to walk on it, and the narrower the better. If he was going to climb up things, instead of saying we're never going to go anywhere, we got a service dog. A big part of her role was to ground him, literally. I mean, the leash is clipped around his waist, and if he even thought about climbing up something, he had to leave the dog behind. So he had to choose between staying with his dog or climbing, and the dog was very motivating to him. Wouldn't it be great if you could go out in public with any kid that has a difference or any person that has a difference? If the first thing that crossed people's minds is, well, maybe there's something going on, or maybe they're struggling. Maybe I could help.
Adele, come here. Thanks, Mom.
Okay, now throw it. Good job, Tommy. That's a good job. You did a good job.
Thanks, Mom.
Yeah, you did a really good job.
And here's the thing. Tommy never gives up. Tommy, who has, in my opinion, more challenges to face on a daily basis than almost anyone I know. Tommy, in spite of that, faces the world with extreme joy, really. Like, he goes forth knowing that it's going to be hard, and he still keeps a smile on his face, and he forges ahead. And I figure if Tommy can do that, then we need to do that too.
You know, I'm sorry if I was thinking about your grandma. He was getting killed by Scar, the meanest, scariest lion in the whole movie called The Lion King.
What would make it easier for families of people with autism, for the individuals with autism themselves, is if the world could accept it more. So we signed him up for Facebook, but Tommy had gotten onto YouTube, and Tommy started to tell me that YouTube was where he wanted his videos to be. So now he had, like, the YouTube videos going, the Facebook account going, and both of those were actually really helping, not only helping Tommy to get to know others on Facebook, but I believe it was really drawing people in to know more about Tommy. It's like a window into his world, and it's a way of actually getting to know somebody with autism.
You want to marry me, don't you?
Yes, I want to marry you.
I think people are attracted to him partly because there's something genuinely honest, and really, naive and honest.
Oh, okay.
What kind of a face do you make when you look at... That's the face.
See you later. See you next time. I hope.
There's a like almost a Peter Pan quality about him because he has this... Like, honestly, like, if you're willing to follow him, you kind of get a trip to Neverland. So there's something about Tommy that sort of reawakens the child in people. He acts on those impulses that we all have. If you saw beautiful flowers, you might want to bend over, stick your nose right in them, and take a big whiff, and then go, flowers!
This pink yellow flower tree.
And you know what? He would do it. That's the whole thing, is if you're walking along and you hear some really, really captivating music and other people might stop and maintain their cool stance and kind of listen, Tommy literally unclips the dog, hands the leash to someone and dances. He just starts to dance. And he doesn't live life on the sidelines.
Uh-huh.
And I think others sometimes watch him and think, like they kind of, they wish they had that freedom. They wish they had that that reckless abandon to just go like, that's what I want to do and I'm going to do it. Well, Tommy was about 14 the summer that we decided he would start running. And I kept saying to my husband, you should take him running with you because Peter is a runner. And he was saying, oh, no, he won't. You know, we didn't think he would cooperate to run in the right direction because even though he'd been a runner, he always had his own agenda. What we did more than anything with Tommy was we would honor the things that he was excited about and the things he wanted to do. And we would actually take those things and run with it. We as a society put a lot of emphasis on athletic achievement. So athletics have been really good for Tommy socially. What I would like to see is that people get respected and admired and enjoyed for exactly who they are. Tommy, from a really young age, had an incredible imagination, probably fueled by his Disney movies, but definitely something extraordinary. And it's been said that imagination is the highest kite that one can fly. And I would say that Tommy, definitely, his kite is a little different than some, but it flies just as high.
Should we tell him?
Tell him what?
I think you should.
You can tell him.
So Tommy, do you want to go flying in a little plane?
Yeah, I like that.
A little small plane?
A small plane. I wanted to grow up and start learning some driving lessons on a little plane.
Oh, well, today we're just gonna ride. I've seen everything when I see a Tommy fly.
Oh. When I see a Des Brisay fly.
Yep.
When I see an elephant fly remix.
Okay, sing that remix.
I've seen a peanut stand, heard a rubber band, I've just winked his eye. But I'll see everything when I see a Des Brisay fly. But I'll see everything when I see a Des Brisay fly.
Without Tommy, I don't know who we'd be as a family, right? I mean, that's true of any family, right? But I feel like Tommy's autism is a big part of our identity as a family. But like everything in life, you sometimes say, why me? But now, like more and more now, as he gets older and things get calmer and easier and he's having more successes and he communicates more, now when I say, why me, what I'm saying is, why did I get so lucky?